This one is Danny Kirwan's Something Inside of Me. It's in B minor, and this is the chord you would use. And this is the scale notes that he's using. Okay, with a few bends in there as well. So I'm going to play it along with the backing track that I've done, see what it sounds like. Yes, there's something inside of me, and it just won't go away. Yes, there's something inside of me, and it just won't go away. Yes, it was the blues you gave me when you left me, oh, when you left me that day. Okay, so I'll break those phrases down for you. So the very first one, nice and simple, it goes. Okay, so there we're starting on the 9th fret. And just finish off on that one, on that note there, on the 3rd string on the 7th fret, which is a flattened 7th. Of that scale. Okay, that was nice and easy. The next one, you need to bend up a full note on the 10th fret 2nd string, so it's. Now he's added in there a little flattened 5th note, which is that note. And again, he's finished on that same note there, that flattened 7th there. So that phrase again. And then he does this. So that's on the 9th fret, 3rd string, and he just bends up a full tone. Okay, so the full phrase. So one of the tricky things with some of this playing is getting the phrasing and the timing right. So I think of this as a 1 and then a slow 5 afterwards. And then just finishing off on that one. So it's 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. That's the way I think of it anyway. Alright, the next phrase goes like this. Once more. And again, he's finished on that same note, that flattened 7th note there. And then he plays this quite nice phrase, which is quite slow. So he bends up from the 10th fret on the 3rd string, 9th fret, sorry, on the 3rd string. Sorry, do that again. So now he's finishing on the root note here, a B on the 4th string. Okay, so the next one is just a variation on that. And notice again, he's finishing on that flattened seventh note again. Okay, the next phrase is. Now you could bend that up with your little finger, or you could use your third finger if you like, and that would be on the 10th fret on the second string, so it'll be. So I count that in as a 1-2 and then a quick 3, so 1-2, 1-2-3. Okay, the next phrase. And again, I'm actually using my third finger to hit these notes, which are 4 frets apart. You quite easily use your little finger if you like. I just think your third finger, you've just got a bit more strength with it, so you can put a bit more power into it. Okay, and the last couple of phrases are. Now you can barely hear those last 3 notes actually on the song, but they are there. And then the very last phrase, which brings us to the stopping part, is this. So you're literally just playing a little arpeggio over here. Those 3 notes there, that's all it is. You finish off with these 3 notes and just play them all together as a stabbing chord. Okay, that's the first part.